Okay, good morning. We are on right before the Mishnah, Samech Tes on the base, bottom line. Sok the Gemara, Ben Velo Bas, Tanya Amar Rabbi Shimon, Bidin Hushetahe Bas Riolios Keben Sorer Mora. It's a Ben Sorer Mora, not a Bas Sorer Mora, but really it should be a Ben Sorer Mora and a Bas Sorer Mora. What's the difference? A woman can become gluttonous just like she could become anything else. Just like a man can become gluttonous and a man can steal and get addicted to meat and wine, etc. So could a woman. Shakol mitzuyin, etzla b'aveira, and she can cause others to sin as well. El gzeiras hakasavu, what do you want me to do? The Torah says, ben velo bas. Zok the Mishnah, me'ema sechayev. From when are you chayev as a ben sorer mora? Again, the underlying idea is that we're worried about an addiction and about stealing money and buying meat and wine and continuing in the addiction and ultimately leading to come and kill somebody. So we stop him. So when's he chayiv? How much meat and wine does he have to drink? Mishayochal tartimar basar v'yishte chatzi lug yayin ha'italki. You need to eat a tartimar or basar, which we'll see how much that is in a second. It's half of a mana. And you have to drink half of a lug of Italian wine, which is addictive and nice. Rabbi Yossi omer, mana basar, needs to be a mana basar, the lug yayin, and a lug of yayin. And the Gemara learns that since he says double the amount by the lug, chatzi lug for the Tanakhama and lug for Rabbi Yossi. Therefore, we learn that when he says tartimar, the Tanakhama, it must be that when Rabbi Yossi says mana, he's doubling it as well, and therefore tartimar must be half of a mana. Acha bechaburas mitzvah. If the guy eats as part of a chaburas mitzvah, a siyum or a kiddush or something like that, if it's a chaburas mitzvah, so then lemaisa, we're not worried he's going to become addictive from that. He knows that it's part of a mitzvah, and that's the only reason that he's drinking wine and eating meat. Therefore, he would not become a ben sorer from a chaburas mitzvah. Achal be'ibra chodesh. He used to have a meal to celebrate the ibra chodesh when they would go out and make the chodesh 30 days. It was either 29 days or 30 days. So when they would make it 30 days, they would have a little bit of meal. And seemingly, as we'll see, without wine and meat, but at this point with wine and meat. And if he ate wine and meat at that meal, we're not worried since it's quote-unquote for a mitzvah, really to publicize Rosh Chodesh and publicize the extra day. So he's not going to be chayiv if he eats meat and wine at that meal. Acha ma'aser sheni b'Yerushalayim. Similarly, if he takes the money from ma'aser sheni that he's poda, and he takes the money to Yerushalayim and buys meat and wine with it and eats it, even if he eats the right amount, he's not a ben sorer mora, as the Gemara explains, because he's doing exactly what the pasuk says: take the money to Yerushalayim and buy meat and wine. Achal nevelos trefos shkatzim v'ramasim. If he eats nevelos trefos shkatzim v'ramasim, if he eats non-kosher food, that's not considered to be meat. Most of the Rishonim take out the following line because Tevel, Maaser Rishon, etc. does not apply to meat. It only applies to Yayin and it doesn't apply to meat. So seemingly, again, some learn that it's talking about the Yayin. Others are saying that it just gets taken out totally. Achal davar shu mitzvah v'davar shu avera. If you eat something that's a mitzvah and something that's an avera, achal komacha v'lo achal basa. If you eat a macha but not basa, shasa komashke v'lo shasa yayin. If you drink a mashke but you don't drink Yayin. So again, mitzvah and avera, we'll see what that means. Again, seemingly chaburas mitzvah is a mitzvah. Then there's other things that are for shame mitzvah and things that are for shame avera. You don't go ahead and you don't get punished for. You're not a ben sorer mora. It has to be a macha v'lo achal basar, shasa komashka v'lo shasa yayin. If you eat any other food but not basar, not yayin, einu nasa ben sorer mora, shiyochal basar v'yishti yayin. Why? Because the pasuk says, shenemar zolel v'sovei. V'yav v'bi she'ein raya l'davar zeich l'davar. How do you know that zolel v'sovei means meat and wine? Shenemar al tehik b'sovei yayin. That's wine. Bizolele basar lamo. So zolel is meat, sove is wine, and you have a raya ledover from the pasuk in Mishlei. Zog the Gemara. Amar bizera. Tartemer ze eni odea mahu. I don't know what tartemer is in the Tanakam. I don't know how much meat that is. Elamitosha kofal Rabbi Yossi biayin nimsa kofel af bibasar v'nimsa tartemer chatzimana. Since at the end of the day, it's double the amount in Rabbi Yossi from the Tanakhama, so it's double the amount in Rabbi Yossi to the Tanakhama for the basar as well. Amar Rav Chanan Bar Molda, Amar Rav Huna, Eino Chayiv at Sheyikach Basar Bezol V'Yochal, Yayin Bezol V'Yishta, Dichsiv Zolel V'Sovei. You're only Chayiv when he buys cheap, which is interesting because we just said Italian wine in the Mishnah. But it has to be cheap basar and cheap wine. Why? Because we're not worried you're going to become addicted to expensive stuff. It's only this cheap stuff that you can become addicted to. It's going to be easy to steal and get more. But if it's a very expensive food or very expensive wine, you're not going to become addicted because you're not going to be able to afford it. So at the end of the day, lemaisa, it has to be cheaper wine and cheaper meat. Amar of Chan and Bar Molda, Amar of Huna. Furthermore, Eino chayev at sheyochal basar chay, v'yishta yayin chay. He's only chayiv when he eats raw meat and undiluted wine. They used to dilute their wine. Ini, is that true? What do you mean? It's a contradiction. Just that if you eat raw wine and undiluted wine, you don't become a ben sora mora. And you just said that you're only chayiv if you eat undiluted wine and raw meat. What's the answer? Amar Ravina, no. What Rav Huna is saying when he says, mazig. It means partially diluted. Basar chai, bashir velo bashil, ki basar kiva de achle ganve. Like the ganavmi. What's that? Macha ben drusai. So what's he saying? He's saying if the meat is totally raw or the wine is totally undiluted, then lemaisa it's disgusting. He's not going to become addicted to it. If it's partially cooked, it means, like I always order, medium rare. If it's medium rare or it's partially diluted, that's kishmak, and that you're going to become addicted to. As Rashi seems to add, even if it's fully diluted, the way that everybody goes out and drinks it, that's not going to be an issue either. That's not going to be ben sora or mora either, because it's fully diluted. So lemaisa, even though that's how people used to drink it, you're not going to become addicted to it. So it sounds like when he says that it's basar chai, and it has to be yain chai, it's like somewhere in the middle. It's like semi-cooked, it's like medium rare, and it's semi-diluted. That's the most kishmak way to eat meat and the most kishmak way to drink wine, and that's what he's going to become addicted to. If it's totally undiluted or totally raw, or it's too diluted or too cooked, lemaisa, he's not going to become addicted to that, and he's not going to be considered to be a ben sora mora if he eats or drinks that. Zok the Gemara. Rabbi Rav Yosef Dami Tavayu. Acha basar meliach v'shasa yayin migito einasa ben sora mora. Now, we're talking about partially cooked versus fully cooked, etc. So we're going to talk about now the minimum amount. So the minimum amount is that if you eat yayin migito from the wine vat, so that's not ben sora mora, because you're not going to become addicted to it, because again, that's straight from the wine vat is not going to taste very good. You're not going to become addicted to it. And basar, if it's salted, then you can't become a ben sora mora. Now, it doesn't sound like we're talking about basar that we saw like every other basar. It sounds like after they finished salting it, after the shechita, they would salt it more. We'll have to see exactly what that means. What does it mean when it's straight from the vat, and what does it mean that it's salted too much? It's not hasam. Erev tishabav lo yochal adam shnei tafshilin v'lo yochal basar v'lo yishta yayin. So it seems like whatever is not going to make you a ben sora morer is also what you're allowed to eat on Erev tishabav. What does that mean? You don't want to have a festive meal on Erev tishabav. So you can't have two tafshilin, you can't eat wine, and you can't eat basar. V'tanem, we said, aval ochel hu basar meliach v'shosa yayin migito. So again, it seems to be the same thing. We just said a ben sora mora is not going to become addicted to stuff that's too salted or straight from the vat. Therefore, since that stuff's not so good, so too on Erev Tisha B'Av, you can eat meat that's too salted and you can drink wine that's straight from the vat, but other meat, which is better, the ben sora mora cannot eat, or else he's going to become a ben sora mora. There's ben sora mora cannot drink, and so too you can't eat and drink on Erev Tisha B'Av. It seems to be the same exact thing. Basar Meliach Hakama, when we say that it's too salted, that up to a certain amount you're allowed to eat, that's geshmak, but after that it's too salted. What does that mean? Amar Rabbi Chanina Bar Kahana calls manchahu kishlamim. What's a shlamim? A shlamim, not in terms of salted. A shlamim you can eat for 2 days and one night. So if after it's totally shechted and everything, if you salt it up to 2 days and one night, it's still geshmak. Once it's been salted for 2 days and one night, and now you can no longer eat quote-unquote a shlamim, just as a comparison, now it's considered to be too salty, and it's not geshmak. And you can eat that on Erev Tisha B'Av, and a ben sora mora will not be chaya for eating that. V'yayin migito at kama calls manchu toses. What is a ben sora mora when he eats, when he drinks it? He's not going to be considered to be a ben sora mora. And you're allowed to drink it on Erev Tisha B'Av. What is that? While it's still fermenting. Until it's still fermenting, it's not geshmak. While it's still fermenting. Once it's fermented, then it's a geshmak wine. V'atanya, but we see yayin toses ein bo mishum giloy. Similarly, we see that yayin toses, if it's still fermenting, there's no din of uncovered liquids, which you have to throw out, you're not allowed to leave out because of the snakes, because since it's not very good, the snakes are not going to drink it either. V'kama tisisas, another Gemara adds, how much is tisas? So how long does it take to ferment? Shlosha yamim, 3 days. So again, my liach, up to 2 days and one night, that still can be considered good, gishmak basar. Once it's been salting for 2 days and one night, it's salted too much and it's not gishmak. And similarly, until it ferments for 3 days, it's not so gishmak. Once it ferments for 3 days, then it's very gishmak. Says the Gemara, hachamai. The Gemara seems to be making a difference now between ben sora and mora and the case of Erev Tisha B'Av. Hasam ishum simchahu calls manchu kishlamim nami yisbe simcha. Hacham ishum imshuchehu uvecholhu uvechol shehu lo mimshich v'yayin ad mem yom. Now the Gemara says, no, there's a little bit of a chiluk between Erev Tisha B'Av and a ben sora mora. By Erev Tisha B'Av, it has to do with simcha. Therefore, it's like we said. By simcha, where is it a geshmak piece of meat? It's a geshmak piece of meat when it's like a shlamim. If it hasn't been salted for too long, if it hasn't been salted for 2 days and one night, that's a geshmak piece of meat. But over here, it's because of imshuche. What does that mean? Mashach. To be pulled towards something, to be addicted to something. When it's addicted to something, b'kol shehu lo mamshech. He's saying it's even less. It's like a chumer that's asi lidei kula, or a kula that's asi lidei chumer, however you want to put it. Lemaisa, you can eat on Erev Tisha B'Av, you can't eat more meat. That means you can't eat any meat until it's been salted for 2 days. For Ben Sorer Morer, he's going to be putter, even if it's been salted a little bit too much. Even if it's been salted for only 1 day, he's no longer a Ben Sorer Morer. Once it's been salted even a little bit too much, he's not going to become addicted to it. So too by Yayin Migito. By Yayin Migito, by fermenting, until it's fermenting for 3 days, Lemaisa, you're allowed to drink it on Erev Tisha B'Av. Once it fermented for 3 days, you're not allowed to drink it on Erev Tisha B'Av. By a Ben Sorer Morer, even if it fermented already for 3 days, that's not enough. He'll only become addicted if it fermented for 40 days. If he drinks wine that hasn't been fermented yet for 40 days, he will not become a Ben Sorer Morer. So again, I don't know if you want to say it, a Chumra or Kula, there's going to be a smaller amount of cases that a Ben Sorer Morer will become a Ben Sorer Morer than the amount of cases you're allowed to drink wine and eat meat on Erev Tisha B'Av. There's going to be more cases where you can't drink that wine or eat that meat by Erev Tisha B'Av than the number of cases that will make this guy a Ben Sorer Morer. It's a much more limited amount of things and items. Zakta Gemara. Amar Rav Chanan. Talk about why Kiddush clubs are bad. Lo nivra yayin ba'olam el lanachem aveilim ulishalem schar lirashayim. Shenamar tenu schar le'oive to a rush of a yayin lamari nafesh. Yayin is in this world in order to help people have nechama when they're aveilim, and in order to pay the schar to the Rishayim. So the Rishayim drink in this world, and then they get schar for it, and then when they go to the next world, they don't get schar because they already enjoyed. It's interesting because by Nacham Avelim, I believe, correct me if I'm wrong, I believe that by Sfardim, they don't drink wine or eat meat the entire time of the Shiva. By Ashkenazim, it's only during the Aninus, between the time of the death and the burial. But after the burial, so Ashkenazim actually eat wine, drink wine and eat meat. And again, it seems to be some type of nechama for the Avelim to be able to drink a little bit of wine. And that's what Yayin is for, but not to drink and get drunk, etc. Amar Yitzchak Maidich Siv, we're going to discuss a few problems with wine. Altera Yayin Ki Yisadeim, don't look at or i.e. indulge in wine because it becomes red. Altera Yayin Shema Adim Panem Shavashayim Ba'olam Hazu Malbim Panem Lo'olam Haba. Don't indulge in wine because it makes your face red in this world. It's geshmak in this world, but you're going to turn white in the next world. Because when you get to the next world and you want to collect your schar, you're going to say, sorry, man, you already got your schar in this world, in the last world. Lamaisa, you're going to turn white because you have no schar in Olam Haba. Rav Amar Altera Yayin Ki Yisadeim, Altera Yayin Shachariso Dam. Don't indulge in wine because it's going to lead to dam. It's going to lead to blood. Either you're going to kill other people or you might kill yourself. Rechman Latzan Rav Kahana Ram Iksiv Tirash Vekarinan Tirosh. Zacha, if you're Zocha, Nasa Rosh. Wine can help you go to the head of the line. If you have it in the right amounts, it can really help you succeed in life. Lo Zacha, Nasa Rosh. But if you overindulge or use it inappropriately, you'll become poor. Similarly, Rav Rami Ksiv Yismach Vikarin and Yismach. Zacha, Misamcho. If you're Zocha, it'll make you happy. Lo Zacha, Mishamemeyu. If you're not Zocha and you overindulge and you use it inappropriately, it will destroy you. Hainu Dama Rava. Rava said, I had the right amount of wine. I had a good balance. Chamra Verechne. Pichin. I had the right amount of wine and the right amount of scents, S-C-E-N-T, smells, and lemaisa, I was able to become a bikech because of it. Amar Rav Amram Breda Rav Shimon Baraba Amar Rav Chanina Maidichsev Lemi Oi, Lemi Avoi, Lemi Medanim, Lemi Siach, Lemi Psaim Chinam, Lemi Chachlilo Seinayim, Lemi Achim Al Yain, Levoim Lachor Mimasech. These are all bad things, Oi, Voi, that are happening to people that are drinking too much wine. Kiyos Rav Dimi Amar Amar Biravava Haikra Mandadarish Le Mireisha Lesefa, Midarish Mesefa Lereshe Madrish. You can either go from this beginning to the end or the end to the beginning. It means either it's questions or it's all statements. But either way, the point is the same, that if you overindulge in wine, bad things will happen. Darish Ovar Galila. Yud Gimel Vavin Nemru B'Yayin. By the Parsha of Noach, there were 13 Vavs, as we're about to see. And the Vavs stand for Oy Vey. Oy, like Voy. Lemaisa, there were 13 Vavs. And Lemaisa, each one stands for Voy because of the Yayin that Noach had. Where does it say 13 by Yayin? So it says, Vayachel Noach, Ishad Nama Vayitakarn Vayesh, Mina Yayin Vayishkar, Vayitkal Betocha Lo Vayarchama Vikanan Eser Vasaviv, Vayagil Shneachi Bachuds Vayikach Shem Vayafes Esasim Lo Vayasim Ashchem Shnehem Vayelcha Achronis Vayichasu Eser Vasavihem, Ufnehem Achronis Vier Vasavihem Lo Ro, Vayikets Noach Mieno, Vayedes Asher Asalo Benoha Katan. Rav Shmuel Chadamar, what did Cham do, the famous Gemara, what did Cham do to him? Either he castrated him, or he sodomized him. Chadamar Sirisu. Cham castrated Noach, v'chadamar rivo, or he sodomized him. Mandi amar sirsu. He said he castrated him, it made sense. Because what did Noach do? Noach cursed Cham's fourth child. He couldn't curse Cham. Hashem had given a certain type of bracha to Cham. He cursed his fourth child, who was Kenan. So at the end of the day, why did he curse his fourth child? So if you say that he castrated him, it makes a lot of sense. Mitosha kilkalo berevi, kilo berevi. Since he prevented Noach from being able to have a fourth child, because he castrated him, Lamaisa, he cursed his fourth child. Umandi amarivo, and the one who says that he went ahead and he sodomized him, where do you learn that from? Gemar vayar vayar. He saw by Shechem and Dina vayar osam Shechem ben Chamor. Shechem saw Dina and he raped her. Bishlam alamand amar sirus mishumachi kilo berivi alamand amar deba rivo maishna berivi nalte ba'adai. Why specifically did he curse the fourth child if it was just that he sodomized him? If he castrated him, I understand. You caused me to not have a fourth, I'm going to curse your fourth. But if he sodomized him, what's the connection between that and the fourth child? Says Gemara, havaha havi. You're right. Really, if he just went ahead and he sodomized him, you're right. But he might say he did both. Since he did both, he chose he's going to curse him. He's going to curse him anyway. He's going to curse him out the castrating part, and he's going to curse his fourth son, Kenan. It's a machlokes what the eighth hadas was. It's not going to say esrog here, and that's one of the suggestions. There are those who suggest it was an esrog tree. It's not one of the suggestions here. Says the Gemara, Amalei HaKadosh Baruch Hu Noach. What did he say to him? Noach! Didn't you learn from Adam HaRishon who sinned with wine? How can you go ahead and plant a vineyard after the Mabul? This goes according to Mandamar that Adam ate from a Geffen, from a vine. Detanya Rabbi Meir Omer Os Vilan Shachal Adam HaRishon Mimenu Geffen Haya She'ein Lecha Davar Shemevi Yelala LeAdam Eliyayin. It only brings wailing to a person, only yayin. Rabbi Yehuda Meir, what was it? It wasn't a wine, he argues. Chita yashen, a tino gyodeh likur abba v'imach yitum tam dagan. A kid, the first thing he eats is dagan, is a little bit of wheat, some wheaties. At the end of the day, if that's the first thing that a child eats, that's the most common type of tree that there is. Therefore, it must have been a wheat tree or wheat bush. Rabbi Chem Yomer, what was it? Te'enaya. It must have been a fig. Shebedavar shakilkalo boniskano shenemar vayatfru ale te'ena. At the end of the day, since we see that they fixed at the end of the day when they were naked, so they went and they put on figs, it must be that they fixed themselves with the same thing that they sinned, which were figs. So either it was a fig tree, or it was chita, or it was yayin, or according to some, not in this Gemara, it was an apple tree or an esrog tree. So the Gemara, we have now, very interesting, Batsheva, Shlomo's mother from David, Batsheva gives Musa to her son for overindulging in the world. Divrei Lemuel Melech, Lemuel being Shlomo, Masa Asher Yisratu Imo. His mother went ahead and gave him Musa. What did she say? Amr V'yochan Mishim Rabishim Menuchai Milamed Shekafaso Imo Al Amr. Doesn't work today. She bound him up on the Amr. For Amr Lo, and she said to him, Ma Barei, my son, Ma Bar Bidni, the son of my Beten, Uma Bar Nidri, the son of my Neder. What does that mean? Mabri, you're my son. Oy vey, my son. Hakol yodim shavicha yerushamayim avach shavyamu imo garmalo. My son, what did she mean? Everybody knows that your father David is a yerushamayim. So when they see you overindulging and not being a yerushamayim, they're going to say, ah, oh, it must be from the mother's side. Uma bar bitni, you're the son of my bet. And kol anashim shalbeis avicha kevin shemisava shuvei neros pnei amelach. Most people, once they become pregnant, the melech doesn't want to see them anymore, and they just say, okay, no problem. Melech doesn't want to see pregnant women, you can just go and have non-pregnant women. Look what I did for you. I went and I dafka kept going to David, even though he preferred not to see pregnant women. I went and I pushed my way in because I wanted to make sure that you get all of his good qualities. And now you're treating me like this, and you're going and you're overindulging in wine and in other things in the world. Uma bar nidri, you were the son of my neder. Kol anashim shel beis avicha, you know, dros all the other sons. Yehali ben hagun lemalchus. They were all davening and saying, I'll do this, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. I'll take a neder to do this if you take care of me and make my son roi lemalchus. I didn't care about the malchus. Vanina darti remarti yehali ben zariz umemula betoira. Vahagun lenevius. This is what we should be davening for. Not that our kids should be malchus, and big doctors and lawyers, but that they should be hagun Lemalch Lenevius and Memula Betoira. Next, Al Lemalachim Lemoel, Al Lemalachim Shasu Yain. What does she mean when she said, not for the Malachim, Shlomo, not for the Malachim, drink wine. Al Lemalachim Amr Lo. She said to him, furthermore, Malachaitza Malachim Shasosim Yain, Mishtakim Vomim Lamalanuel. Why are you hanging out with all the kings who are drinking wine and saying, what do we need God for? Vilerosnim Eshechar. Mishako Razi Olam Gluyim Lo, you, Shlomo, who have all of the secrets of the world, Yishta Yain Vishtaker, you're going to drink wine and you're going to get shukar. Ikadamre, others say, Mishako Rosne Olam Ashkim Lepisko, not that you have all the secrets of the world. All the people in the world are coming to you for advice. because you know all the secrets. All the people who want to know the secrets are coming to you for advice. Yishta yain vishtaker. You're going to become a shikr. Come on, man. Amar Rav Yitzchak. Minayin shechazer Shlomo v'hoda lima. Where do we see that Shlomo actually listened to his mother? Dichsiv ki bar anochi me'ish v'lo binas adam li. He says, I am more foolish from ish, and I don't have the bina, the understanding of an adam. Ki bar anochi me'ish. Who am I more foolish than? Minoach. Dichsiv ayochel noach ish adamah. It calls Noach an ish. He says, I should have learned from Noach, who was an ish adamah, that I shouldn't have a plant, I shouldn't drink wine. V'lo binas adam li, ze adam arishon. Adam arishon was called adam, so I should have learned from those two people. Zok the Gemara. You cannot become a ben sorer more if you eat in a chaburas mitzvah, because again, you're not going to become addicted from that food, because you know that you're dafka eating it for a mitzvah. Amar Rabbi Abbo, einu chai v'chiyochal b'chabura shekula suikin. Now it seems like Rabbi Abbo is not talking about chaburas mitzvah. He's saying, besides for chaburas mitzvah, you're only going to be a ben sorer more if you eat in a chabura where everybody is suikin, good for nothings. If there's even one person in the chabura, nothing to do with the chaburas mitzvah for a second. If there's even one person in your chabura, you have a kiddush club, and they're all good for nothing except for one guy. If one guy is not a good for nothing, so at the end of the day, we assume that he's going to go ahead and he's going to be able to have good hashpa on you, and therefore you don't become a ben sorer more as long as there's one good guy in the group. But we said in our Mishnah that if you eat a chaburas mitzvah, you don't become a mitzvah mora. Time of the mitzvah. Sounds like the reason you don't become a mitzvah mora is because it's a mitzvah. Chaburas mitzvah. Hai lav mitzvah. Avagav delav kula srikin. Sounds like if it's not a chaburas mitzvah, you become a mitzvah mora even if not everybody's a good for nothing. Zok the Gemara hakamashal de avagav de kula srikin. Kevin de mitzvah kaasa glo mimshach. No, you're reading it wrong. It's either or. Either if you're part of a chaburas mitzvah and everybody's good for nothings, then lemaisa you're still not going to become a ben sorer because you know you're doing it for a mitzvah. Or if you're not part of a chaburas mitzvah, you're part of the kiddush club, but lemaisa there's one guy who's not a good for nothing, then at the end of the day, you will be okay because hopefully he will have hashpa on you and he will rub off and you will not become a ben sorer more. Acha be'ibra chodesh. They had this meal again when they would go ahead and add the extra day. So if you ate in this meal, it's considered to be like a mitzvah meal because you're publicizing Rosh Chodesh, and you're publicizing the extra day, and therefore you cannot become a ben sorer more at that meal. The Meimer de Basra Yain Masko. That sounds like they used to serve Basra Yain at this meal, but the meal we know wasn't so fancy. All they served at the meal was bread and beans. So what does it mean that if you ate Basra Yain at this meal, you're not a ben sorer more? They didn't serve Basra Yain at this meal. So as a Gemara HaKamashal, and this is what it's teaching us. Avagav de ein olin la ela bepas v'kidnis v'ihu asig bas v'yayin v'achal kevan de mitzvah ka'asig l'mamshal. No, you're right. They served beans and bread. This guy came along, he's not the best kid in the world, and he brings basar and yayin with him to this meal. He says, I got the basar and yayin. Even then, since there is basar and yayin there, even then, you're not going to be a ben sorer more, because again, it's still considered to be a chaburas mitzvah, even though they didn't necessarily serve that. Tana Rabbanan, ein olin bibra chodesh pachos me'asar b'nei adam. This meal needed to have 10 people. Vein olin la'ela b'paz dagon v'kidnis. They had bread and beans. Vein olin la'ela l'or iburo. They had it, the meal, on the or iburo. On the night after the 30th day, it means the 30th day came, they added the extra day. Then the following night, going into 31, which is now going into 1, in that night, they had the meal. Vein olin la biyom ela balayla. And they only go biyom, not balayla. V'atanya, but we say in olin la balayla ela biyom. They only went up at night, not during the day. What's going on? Kedamar of Chiyabaraba, Libnei, achrifu va'olu, achrifu upoku. Go up early and come down early. Kehechi de lishmu bachu inshi. It sounds like the Gemara is saying that this meal of Ibra Chodesh took place at night, the night following the 30th day. Again, Rosh Chodesh could either be day number 30 or day number 1. So, or day number 30 or, again, the next day. So over here you had 30 days, then you had this meal. So they did it at night. So what do you mean that they went up during the day? Well, they wanted to publicize the fact that they were adding this extra day of 30. So if they did it at night when everybody was sleeping, then at the end of the day nobody's going to see them going in or going out. So what did they do? They went early. So they would go in while it was still light, while people were still out on the streets. So they would see them going into this room. They wouldn't start the meal till nighttime. And it sounds like what he's saying is that they would leave early enough when people were still out going to work, so that at the end of the day, they wouldn't leave when everybody was ready at work, because then they wouldn't accomplish it. So this way, the meal was actually a night. But they would go in while it was still light. They would go out early while people were going to work. This way, to accomplish what they were trying to accomplish, to publicize as much as possible that we went ahead and we added an extra day to the previous month. Acha Meiser Sheni B'Yerushalayim. If he goes and he takes money and he buys meat and wine in Yerushalayim, he's not going to be considered to be a ben sorer morer, even if he eats the right amount. Why? Kevan dechi orchehu ka'achilei lo mamshech. The Torah tells you that's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to take the wine. You're supposed to take the money that you reported the Meiser Sheni with, bring it to Yerushalayim, and buy animals and buy meat and buy wine. He's doing exactly what the Torah says, right? Doing a mitzvah. What do you want from me? Lamaisa, he did a mitzvah. He's not going to be considered to be ben tzora mor. Achal nevelos trefos shkatzim v'ramasim. What about chicken wings? Amarava. Achal basar of eno nasa ben tzora mor. If you eat chicken wings and too many chicken wings, you're not going to become a ben tzora mor. Sounds like these specific non-kosher foods, you don't become a ben tzora mor. But if you eat chicken wings, enough chicken wings, then you become a ben tzora mor. You become addicted to chicken wings, we all know. Says the Gemara, very interesting. What the Gemara says here is as follows. If you eat a certain amount of meat, whatever it is, the mana of meat, the tartamer of meat, you become a ben tzora mor. We're talking about meat now. If you eat, let's say, 3/4 of the amount you're supposed to eat, and now you eat a quarter of shkatzim v'ramasim, says the Gemara, too bad. Shkatzim v'ramasim, you can't become a ben tzora mor by shkatzim v'ramasim. You can't become a ben tzora mor for eating the entire amount of basar of chicken wings. But if you eat a majority, 51% of regular meat, and you fill in the rest of the shear with chicken wings, then l'maisa you can become a ben tzora mor. So again, you fill in the rest of the shear with non-kosher food, you can't become a ben tzora mor. But if you eat a majority of meat, it just needs to be, I mean, not clear, but I would say 51% of meat, the other 49% of chicken wings, l'maisa, you're good to go, and you're ben tzora mor. Zok the Gemara. Achal davar shu mitzvah v'davar aveira. What does it mean now? Besides for a chabur mitzvah, what does it mean you're doing something for a mitzvah? You're doing something for an aveira. You can't be ben tzora mor. Davar mitzvah tanchume aveilim. If you eat during the tchume aveilim, if you're going out and you're doing nicham aveilim for somebody and you're eating meat while you're there, you can't become ben tzora mor, because again, we're not assuming you're going to be addicted. You're doing it for the mitzvah. And very fascinating. Davar aveira tanis sibor, like today. If a guy goes and eats a lot of meat today, really, we could say he could become addicted because there's no such thing as, oh, I'm doing it for a mitzvah. Well, I said, what do you mean? You're doing it? It's an aveira. It's a town of Sibor. V'taima mai, it sounds like it's Zeres HaKosev. Amar Krai, nenu shomea bekolenu. He doesn't mean listen to his parents. Bekolenu velo bekolo shamakom. Can only become a ben tzora mor when you're just not listening to your parents. But when you're not listening to HaKadosh Baruch Hu or to the rabbis, then you did something wrong, but you can't become a ben tzora mor. Very, very fascinating. Zok the Gemara. There are certain things like basar, but not basar, like yain and not yain. What does that mean? There are certain things like basar, which go ahead and you can become addicted to. You can't become addicted, but they're intoxicating. What does that mean? So you have the thing called figs from kfela. Figs from this keilis, sorry. These things are intoxicating, but they're not addictive. Therefore, even though they're intoxicating, you're not going to be able to come a ben tzora mor from them because they're not addictive. Shasa komashke v'lo shasa yayin, that's a type of food that's intoxicating but not addictive. Liyisuei devash v'chalav, that devash and chalav, I never knew this. Devash and chalav can become, milk and honey can become intoxicating but cannot actually become addictive. Titania, I guess there's a way to make milk into something that's intoxicating. Titania, achal devela ki'ilis v'shasa devash v'chalav v'nichnas l'mikdash chayav. Fascinating. You're chayev because you went into the mikdash in an intoxicating fashion, which you're not allowed to do. You can't become a ben tzora morer, but if you go into the thing, then a regular person, not a kohen. Where? You shouldn't be yayin v'sheichar al teisht. V'kohen askinan. So it could be. I'm not sure. I'm not sure if it's dafka kohen. No, but I'm not sure that it's a kohen. Why? If a regular person is allowed to go into the mikdash drunk? I don't know. I'll have to look into it. Like the Mishnah, what does this last pasuk mean? That you become poor from a sove of isolel and your stuff gets torn if you're a slumberer. Make sure nobody's sleeping now. Anybody who sleeps in the base medrash or during a shir, Torasso nasis lo kroim kroim. Your Torah becomes tattered shenemar ukroim talbish noma. If you slumber, it becomes tattered. Not because it's a curse, because we know if you have no retzifus, if you go ahead and you fall asleep during the shir, you fall asleep during your Torah, so you'd have no continuation, and lemaisa the Torah will not stick.